will be talking about the financing fees Gibson case. So me personally will talk about the summary of the cases. So the case started with the parties entered into a hire purchase agreement for a car. The claimant, a finance company, gave the dealer authority to draw up the agreement on its behalf. The agreement stated that it would only be binding on the claimant once the claimant had signed and accepted it. 2 days later, before the claimant signed the agreement, the defendant informed the dealer that he no longer wanted to go through with the agreement. The night before the claimant signed the agreement, the car was stolen from the dealer. By the time the car was found, it had been damaged. The claimant sued the defendant for the price of the car, minus a deduction for the value of the damage. The defendant then argued that he was not obliged to pay because he had revoked his offer before the claimant signed the agreement. The case then referred to the Court of Appeal, and the Court of Appeal held in favor of the defendant. The dealer acted as the claimant's agent. In that capacity, he had ostensible authority to accept the defendant's revocation of the offer. Since the claimant had to sign the contract to accept the offer and they had not done so before the offer was revoked, therefore, there was no contract. Additionally, the court held that the offer was conditional on the car being in the condition it was when the offer was made. As such, even if the offer had not already been revoked, it was no longer capable of being accepted once the car was damaged. So that is the summary of the case for financing v. Stevenson. So we move on to the next part.
And also a plaintiff. It's a people accused of committing a crime, criminal prosecution, or people against some type of civil release is being sought in civil case, where the terminology varies from one jurisdiction to another. The plaintiff is the one who brings the lawsuit to the court, who is the one who responds is the either defendant or also the respondent. Hence for this case, Mr. Anthony George Stevenson were positioned as defendant, and a company who called as the financing entity was positioned as plaintiff.
Needed for it. already paid. It is unclear what Mr. Gosden's worker said to him, but apparently he told him that Stemmo Motor Company would contact the finance company and tell him the results. It is also recommended that Mr. Stimson should liaise with his own finance company. However, by some oversight, Stemmo Motor Company did not contact the finance company, so did Mr. Stimson. Even so, Mr. Stimson argued that after returning the car, he was no longer responsible for it. Thank you.
Like to talk about the issue and problem that has been raised in this case. The issue and problem that has been raised in this case is to consider the issue of contract offering, whether or not the finance company can accept the motor vehicle purchase offer even if Mr. Stimson has cancelled the offer and returned the car to the dealer. The country court just ruled that given the damage to the car before the acceptance was granted, the finance company could not accept the offer as the condition was met before it was made. Therefore, no contract was produced and the offer was not accepted because Stimson's offer was subject to an implied condition that the car should continue in its undamaged state and that on the failure of the condition, the offer lapsed.
I will move forward with the element of the contract that involved in this case. I will be discussing about the offer and acceptance that has been triggered this case. Regarding the law case that we want to discuss, which is the financing limited versus Stimson's, the offerer of this case made an offer of a motor car to the offeree. The offeree then accept the offerer offers with the conditions that the offerer stated. However, the offer has become void because of the offerer did not fulfill the conditions of the motor car to the offeree. When the defendant voiced out about the offer was invalid, the plaintiff said that the contract has been signed beforehand and led to the acceptance, which is not true at all. Hence, in this case, the acceptance has been revoked as it don't execute the conditions promised by the offerer.
Assalamualaikum and hi, my name is Aja. I'm going to tell you about the solution of the case. So the court found that the dealer had the authority to receive acceptance and also revocation from the purchaser. On this basis, when Mr. Simpson returned the car and revoked his offer, there was no longer a contract for the motor car. Further to this, the Mr. Simpson was owned the car in the same condition as when the offer was made and when the finance company signed the agreement and accepted the contract on March 25, the car was not in the same condition. It's because the car suffered severe damage before the acceptance and there was substantial depreciation as the result. So on that basis, it seems that we should by implication read into this offer in order to give the transaction that business efficacy which parties must have intended to have. An implied condition that this offer is capable of acceptance only if the car remains with the same condition and also the same condition in this case was not fulfilled because the car was severely damaged and its value was substantially depreciated. As the result, there was no agreement and there was no contract.